Welcome, family. If you don't know me, my name is Amber Nicole. Thank you guys for joining my live. And I really want to kind of be honest about today. So I had to sit down and I've been really trying to figure out, like, what is it that I'm doing in my life right now? How am I showing up and helping people with my coaching? I do feel like there's been a shift. There's some things that I need to change. I've been a confidence coach. I was recently certified this year as a mental health coach, but I felt like there was something else besides that. Yes, people need help with mental health, but it's something specific. And I finally got it yesterday, and I got it from something that I had to deal with personally in my own life. So I'm just gonna be really honest with you guys. So yesterday I was going through Walmart checkout, me and my son. I went grocery shopping and I was buying some things for him. And after I went through there, I was standing in the line, and as I was scanning, as the number kept going up and up and up and up, I started feeling like this anxiousness inside of me, like, oh my God, I'm not gonna have enough. I'm not gonna have enough. I'm not gonna have enough. Mind you, I do have enough, but this was just a familiar spirit for me from when growing up living in poverty and not being able to get certain things. When I was younger in my 20s, of being broke and struggling and living in low-income housing and having to really have a feeling of not having enough. And so I had this feeling of anxiousness while I was at the grocery checkout at Walmart, and I'm checking stuff out, and the number went to 100, and it went to 200 something. I'm just sitting there. And then after I got into the car, I still had this anxious feeling. Obviously, I was able to pay for everything. I was good. Financially, I could pay for everything, but I still had this nervous, anxious, familiar spirit within me. And then I got in the car and I had to ask myself, why am I feeling so anxious about something that I can provide? Why am I feeling so anxious about something that I know I could pay for? And something came to me, and I started listening to, I turned on some gospel music. I started listening to Kiara Shear on the song Something Keeps Happening to Me, or something along those lines. And I got through with that moment. And then later on last night, I sat down and I prayed, and I was like, God, what was that? Like, why was I feeling so anxious? Why was I feeling like I didn't have enough? Like, I was going to have to put some stuff back, or like, where was that feeling from? I have had that feeling so many times before, but why am I feeling that now when I have enough? And I asked him, I'm like, Lord, what do your people need? And he said, resiliency. Amber, you've been able to be resilient in every area of your life, from being a 12-year-old pregnant and having your first child in sixth grade. I was able to get through that. From being in a domestic violence relationship for 10 years, I was able to press through that and not harden my heart, but instead learn from that mistake, learn from what I went through, learn what I was going through at that time, taking accountability for what I did in that relationship, meaning I allowed some of those things to happen. And so I had to realize that resiliency is the one key that majority of people do not have today. So many hatred and anger and bitter people are angry because they do not know how to be resilient. They don't know how to get through to the next step. They don't know how to understand that there are ebbs and flows in life, and things happen, and people come and go, and you have to let go of things. And one day the money's here, then the next day it's gone. And one day the friend is here, and the next day they're gone. People pass away. Like, the ebbs and flows of life, so many of us are unable to be resilient. So when I talked to God and asked him, what do you need? What do you need me to start teaching in my coaching? This is what he said to me. You need to start telling people and teaching how resiliency has been a superpower in your life. How everything that I've ever gone through, I still found a level of joy. Let me tell you something really quick. So 2 years ago, my mom passed away, and she died from cancer. And as she was going, I was sitting in the hospital or whatever with her, because we knew she was passing, so it was just a matter of days before she was going to be gone. And as I'm sitting there, there's like this little pond that's like right across the street from there, that's still in the hospital area, but it's right across from there, that's like basically to give us some solitude, because they know that this is heavy. Like, somebody's passing away, somebody's gonna die, this area is heavy, so they give us like a level of beauty to be able to go and look at. So I would go to this pond as I was sitting with my mom. You know, she couldn't talk, she never was coherent, she was literally laying there and just passing away slowly each day. I think I was there for 7 days. Each day slowly she was passing away. And so I went to that pond every day, sometime a couple times a day, because it's heavy, and watching my mom pass away. And I would sit there and I would literally say out of my mouth, this is hard for me to watch my mother pass away. She is a shell of herself as I sit there. However, Lord, I trust you in this moment. I trust that whatever is happening right now, that this is what my mom needs in this moment, and I'm not going to make it about me. I'm going to be here for her and do the best I can, right? So I had to be there for my mother as I watch her pass away and put myself to the side in the moment and still trust that God was doing what needs to be done. That doesn't mean I wasn't sad. I was sad, I cried, I was hurting, I was in pain, but I still was able to be resilient in that moment. And what I've learned is, you lost your dad, so you understand where I'm coming from. I was able to be resilient in that moment and realizing that this is life. People pass away, life goes on, people come and go out of our lives, like I was just saying. And being resilient is so difficult for so many people today, and that is something I've been able to master. I've been able to, and not by suppressing it, I've been able to get through everything by allowing my feelings to pass by. I've been able to get through things through therapy, and I also have a spiritual coach. I've not suppressed anything. I've been open. I've been vulnerable. I've been honest. I coach women on these same practices that I use for myself because I see how much it's able to help me love the people in the world. There's so many people today that don't love people anymore, right? How many times do we hear people talk about how they don't love people, or how men and women are against each other right now? All of it is because they don't have a sense of resiliency, because someone came and hurt you. Someone came and did something in their life. They weren't treated right. Their parents didn't do something right. They grew up in poverty and couldn't get over it. They live in struggling right now, and they can't move past because they're so busy looking at the circumstance. So resiliency is one of those things that you're able to be in that moment, whatever struggle it is you're going through, and you're able to get through it psychologically and emotionally and learn to grow on the other side. You either going to get stronger or you're going to be more fearful. And the problem with so many people today is that you've become so much more fearful of stuff. You're more fearful of love because you've been hurt before. So now you don't trust men and women anymore because you've been hurt. You're more fearful of spending money sometimes because you grew up in poverty and now you're so tight with your money and now you don't want to spend. Some of you don't even want to tithe because of the things that you've gone through in your life financially, and you're holding so tight to things. But that's fear. Fear holds you back. Fear keeps you down. Fear keeps you from moving forward. But when you learn to have a level of resiliency, when you learn to understand that life is always going to life, and it rains on the just and the unjust, it don't matter how great you are as a person. It doesn't matter how wonderful your family is. It doesn't matter how much money you got. There is always going to be something that you are going to have to overcome. And if you let life keep killing you, and you let life keep controlling you, and you let life keep hardening your heart where you can't even be kind and compassionate and empathize with other people, then realize that you are slowly killing yourself because you are not living out the life that God called us to have. We're called to love others. We're called to be open. We're called to guard our hearts, which means there has to be a level of discernment that you have to have with the people. However, resiliency is that one thing that if you learn, when you really, really get how to be resilient, how to stop suppressing it. So many of us are suppressing the pain. A lot of us are keeping it down. Oh, I'm over it. I don't care about it no more. It don't bother me. I'm over her. I'm over him. I'm over it, whatever the case may be. But let me just tell you this. If you have not really sat and thought about whatever it is, that pain point, that person that hurt you, what it is that they hurt you, what you need in your life right now, if you have not went to therapy for it, if you have not talked it out, sat and got a level of understanding of why that hurt you, what you can do now moving forward, what you've learned from, and not from a hurt space, but what you've learned from, meaning how you're going to show up better next time and how you're going to contribute and being more discerning or whatever it is that you need to do in your life, then you probably have suppressed the problem and just said you're done and over with it. And as long as it ain't happening in your life no more, then it isn't a problem anymore. That's not what healing is. Healing is not just, I ain't talking about it. Healing is not, it's not happening no more, so I don't want to deal with it. That's not what it is. Healing and resiliency go hand in hand, because when you are able to heal, then you're able to be resilient to the next thing. Another thing for me that I've learned that I had to do, I'm sitting outside of my balcony, guys. So another thing that I had to learn for myself is when I started healing, there are certain things that used to bother me that didn't bother me anymore. Or that if it bothered me, my time of how angry I was or frustrated I was able to get over it quicker. If someone did something to offend me, sometimes I used to, I would hold on to it. I don't want to talk to them no more. I don't want to have nothing to do with them. They grown. They should know how to do it. It is what it is. I ain't got time. Whatever. And I didn't do that, right? So what I would do is I would just be mad, angry, hold on to it, and just not deal with the person. Bye. I'm out. Cut off game strong. That's how I was. But I had to learn that we're human. I make mistakes too. So I have to let people be human, operate in their humanness, give them grace, because I want to get grace too when I mess up, and I want them to forgive me when I mess up. So I had to dial down on how the cutoff game was strong, unless they deserve to be cut off, right? And sit and realize that maybe they didn't offend me intentionally. Maybe it was a trigger or something that I had within me that I needed to figure out on how to heal from that and move forward. That is resiliency. That is sitting back, being aware, acknowledging that there is a problem, and being able to allow the person that offended me or that did whatever they is that did to me, hurt me in some sort of way, I was able to move past it and not be mad at them forever and ever and ever. If you find yourself right now really holding on to people, unforgiveness, really still blaming people for things in your life, if you find yourself right now really unable to just move on, unable to talk about somebody that frustrated you and just don't want to hear about them, you just got an attitude about them, or you find yourself just really just in unforgiveness, you're allowing that person to continue to control you, and you cannot be resilient when people are controlling you and controlling how you show up. So I don't want to be on here much longer. I really just wanted to share about my moment that I had at Walmart, and that superpower, the resiliency is a superpower, and how I really was struggling for a little bit at that checkout line, but I had to realize that this is not your problem anymore, Amber. However, there is a lot of people that are still struggling with financial problems. There are a lot of people that are still struggling with whatever. It's not even just financial, just in general, there's familiar things that's happening with you that you feel like you just can't get over and you can't move on from. And resiliency is that thing that you need. So being resilient is the one thing that I've learned that so many people don't have today. So if you don't take anything else from my life today, I want you to take this, that if there is somebody that you haven't forgiven, if there is a situation that you can't move on from, if there is something that you're holding on to that's keeping you from being the fullest who you're supposed to be, being able to operate in love, peace, joy, being able to operate in the most joyful that you could possibly be. I don't even know how else to put it. If you find yourself being mad, angry, frustrated, if you're finding yourself not loving people and just not wanting to be bothered, I would say that there is something that you're holding on to. And I challenge you today to figure out what's that thing that hurts you that you have not moved on from. Figure out that thing that's keeping you from actually having an open heart. Figure out that thing that's holding you back from living out the fullest that you can possibly be. Because until you're able to get over that, so many other areas are going to be hindered and held back in your life because you're not able to let go, have an exit strategy, move on to the next so that you can get to the next level that you actually want to be at. Being resilient is something I've been able to master. I've mastered it. So many people don't have it today. I have resiliency. I've been able to trust God. I've been able to do whatever. See, you see haters on here? Those are people who don't know how to be resilient because they can't even keep their mouth shut from saying anything about someone they don't even know. Don't even know me, yet they're going to say angry stuff about me. Why? When I'm speaking love and light. Why? When I'm being enlightening. Why would you say anything angry when I'm only teaching something that's going to help you? Those are people that are be hurt. Brother, sister, whoever that is, I'm praying for you. All right. You guys enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye, guys.